My name is Vincent, and I head up publisher partnerships at MoPub, which is a Twitter company. After high school, I studied law for 3 years, only to realize that I was wasting my time. It took me 3 years to come to that conclusion. 3 years of my life that I will never get back. 3 years that I could have, 3 years that I could have used to develop new skills or learn about a new field. I often thought, how did I get there? The answer? I didn't ask myself the right questions when I had to make one of the most important decisions of my life. I just didn't have the mental ability to articulate a long-term vision of where I wanted to be in the next 3 years, 5 years, let alone 10 years. I looked at different options, but didn't individually challenge them. And I just ended up doing whatever I thought was the most obvious option. When it comes to game developers relying on ads, picking up a monetization platform is the most important decision that you will ever take for the next 3 to 5 years. If advertising is a source of revenue for your business, it will essentially impact every single part of it. Put differently, this 10% revenue uplift that you will get by picking one platform over the other might actually be that small difference that will allow you to develop a worldwide hit in order to become the next Grime Games or Voodoo of this world. When after 3 years of law school I decided not to become a lawyer, I was lucky enough finding a career path that's a much better fit for me. I became a mobile advertising expert, and over the past 7 years, I have had the opportunity to work with some of the most renowned mobile gaming studios. I've seen firsthand how picking the right partner can help you either to remain in business in the worst case scenario, or to scale your business to new heights in the best case scenario. Today, I'm going to run through a comprehensive list of criteria that you should be evaluating when you consider picking up a monetization platform. So, why is it so complicated to pick up a monetization platform? In order to understand why it's not easy as it looks, it's important to take a step back and look at what happened these past 10 years. Firstly, publishers had no other options than to rely on their homegrown mediations. And we all know that homegrown mediations are costly and time-consuming to operate. Luckily, some product managers from AdMob saw a big opportunity to make a difference for developers and went on to found MoPub. For years, MoPub was the only alternative in the market. But with our ecosystem growing and maturing, other solutions went on a mission to tackle this problem, each with their own vision and approach. Fast forward to today, developers now have to deal with a crowded marketplace, and they don't necessarily know which platform to choose. I want to make it clear that competition is healthy, and it's really good for the ecosystem. It's healthy for the publishers because it gives them options and alternatives, but it's also healthy for the platforms, because it pushes the platforms to continuously innovate in order to remain relevant in their space. So, without further ado, I'm going to walk you through a comprehensive framework to rely on when you do your due diligence with the different platforms that you plan to consider. Essentially, this presentation boils down to three themes: the commercial aspect of the relationship between the platform, between you, the platform, and your users; the platform robustness and its capabilities; and lastly, the long-term vision of the team behind it. So, when it comes to commercial, the first area that we're going to explore is terms. Well, the first area that you developers are going to explore are terms. So, the first question you will be asking is, what is the business model of the platform that I will be working with, and will it incentivize a certain behavior? In other words, does the platform that you will be working with also sell media? And if that's so, are you comfortable working with a platform that by definition will be biased? Moving on to the service, you need to get to know the team that will work alongside you. Do you have a dedicated resource to walk you through the key features of the platform or throughout the onboarding journey? Or will you have to deal with an email alias? Other questions that you should be asking at this point is, where is the team located? What is their SLA? What's the technical support look like? These are all very valid questions that you need to ask yourself at this stage. Moving on to the demand access. So here, it's pretty straightforward, but essentially, you you really need to, you want to ask yourself, what are the partners I'll be able to work with and how easy is it going to be? Essentially, the platform that you will be working with, you might want to find a platform that supports out of the box all the major mobile ad networks. You really don't want to have to think about this and let the platform do the heavy lifting when it comes to certifying networks, updating SDK adapters, and so on. But that's not it. Chances are that you will have traffic coming from countries where those global ad networks won't have good demand, and you will be relying on local ad networks that only them have good demand for you to rely on. So in those cases, you might want to be able to plug in seamlessly either their SDK. You might want to plug in seamlessly the SDKs from those local ad networks, or worst case scenario, to integrate them through the JavaScript tag. Last but not least, depending on your commercial appetite or strategy, you might want the ability to execute commercial partnerships. Whether that's direct sold campaigns, cross-promotional campaigns, or private marketplace, you will need a fully fledged ad server that you can rely on. So ad serving is actually a great segue to touch on the platform capabilities. At MoPub, we're lucky to rely on one of the most robust infrastructure in the world, and thus, thanks to Twitter. I tend to take this for granted, but there's really a massive human and financial cost associated behind this. I mention this because when it comes to infrastructure, it's important to ask yourself, is this platform I'm considering have a backbone solid enough without downtime? You must understand that if your monetization platform servers go down, your business will go down. So how confident are you in the platform's ability to support your business as you keep scaling it? Your first interaction with the platform will be through its SDK. And beyond the traditional questions, how easy it is to integrate your SDK, ask yourself the following questions instead. Is it open source? Can I make some alterations and some modifications to the SDK to make it fit my needs? How often is it updated? What's the documentation look like? Is it modular? And if so, can I strip off some components of the SDK that I don't use to make the SDK as light as possible? Is the SDK going to be compatible with the game engine that I use to develop my apps? Once your team has tackled the SDK piece, the next step will be to add the apps to the UI and start creating the ad units. In the gaming environment, we're looking primarily at rewarded video, full screen, and banners. But what is true for one game might not be true for future games. You might want to keep your options open. By that, I mean that other formats such as MREC or native ads, for instance, could become relevant in future gameplay and therefore will bring you an additional source of income. Beyond the format themselves, you want to evaluate how the platform handles those formats when it comes to ease of integration, pre-caching, latency, but also control around showing either a video, a playable, or a static creative, depending on the user profile interacting with your game at a very precise moment. Excuse me. Last but not least, an important criteria to evaluate is the flexibility of the platform. Whenever on the lookout for a new platform or service, companies always look for the perfect solution that will fit their needs. The reality is that this product doesn't exist and never will. As you scale your business and operations, your needs and expectations change. Therefore, when picking up a platform, you must force yourself to look beyond the fancy, good-looking dashboard that the sales team is putting in front of you. When reviewing MoPub's top customers, remember the slide that I showed you at the beginning, they all have their own way of using our platform. Actually, most of them took it a step further and developed their own stack on top of the MoPub platform, because only they know what they really need and how they really want to handle their operations. Having a long-term vision in this instance is important, because you don't want to be stuck with a platform that won't allow you to grow, that won't allow you to grow at the same pace of your business. By picking a flexible platform, you might spend a bit more time at the beginning setting it up, but I can assure you that long term, it will always pay dividends. The last thing you really need to consider when choosing a monetization platform is innovation. There are many examples of ways to be innovative, so to bring this to life, for this section, I'm going to focus on MOPUP specifically and highlight our approach and mindset when it comes to innovation with three key examples. And this is the first one. As you all know, Unity is one of the most popular game engines in mobile. At MOPUP, we committed to make it easier for developers to get started. For apps built on Unity, developers can now integrate and update the MOPUP SDK and supported network adapters with just the click of a button. This new MOPUP plugin drastically reduces the amount of time developers need to spend on those steps, so they can spend more time building games. Actually, even gaming-first monetization platforms don't provide such level of integration, which shows how much care MOPUP put into supporting the Unity developer community. User-level data has been one of the most major themes in the industry for the past 12 months. For those not familiar with the concept, it essentially bridged the gap between user acquisition and monetization in order to provide insights on the buy side with the goal to improve the return on ad spend. Unlike existing solutions in the market providing far from accurate data, MOPUP impressions level revenue data solution enables publishers to leverage data at different granularity levels to better understand their users and optimize monetization. This enables publishers to do three things: accurately calculate ad LTV, make informed UA decision by flagging actual versus estimated metrics, and tailor in-app user experience by either informing whether you need to show an IAP event or an ad to a user. But that's not it. We also give the ability to the developer to either process the data themselves or to send the data directly to a third-party partner for reporting. We've all heard about in-app header bidding for the past 18 months or so now. MOPUP actually started paving the way for the rest of the ecosystem in early 2018 by partnering with Facebook to take the concept from desktop to in-app. And we call it advanced bidding. Since then, a lot of other platforms followed and started developing their own version of it. Again, as I mentioned in the introduction, competition is healthy for the ecosystem. That said, when it comes to evaluating a new technology, it's worth looking at what's under the hood and understand the DNA of the company behind it. When it comes to advanced bidding and MOPUP, it's 8 years of expertise operating the first and largest mobile RTB exchange, as well as the most popular mediation platform out there. And today, with this product, we aim to enable mobile ad networks to participate in a fair and unified auction with the goal to drive publishers' yield up, but also to improve operational efficiencies by simplifying the ad management setup and reduce latency from cascading down the waterfall. In conclusion, when it comes to innovation, look out for attention to detail of the platform, their ability to think forward, as well as the DNA of the team behind it. For my last slide, I want to leave you with some concrete action items. So once you're done with your due diligence, you might want to shortlist 2 to 3 platforms and start testing. Take some time to set your KPIs in advance and clearly communicate them to the platform. The most common measure of success these days is ARPDAU, which stands for Average Revenue Per Daily Active User. But other factors should be taken into consideration. Remember, it's a long-term decision that you're taking here. So factors like latency, number of crashes, demand access, technical support, are equally important parameters that you should be taken into consideration. Make your test as fair and measurable as possible. Aim to compare apples to apples. Comparing two different apps with a different ad format mix won't be conclusive. Last but not least, The reality of today is not the reality of tomorrow. Keep an open mind. Challenge your platform of choice when your needs change. And keep an eye out on what the rest of the ecosystem is doing and where it's heading. Thank you for listening.
Can you speak about the uplift that you've seen from the in-app header bidding solution for publishers?
Sure. So we're still in the process of evaluating it by conducting different A/B tests. But I'm happy to announce that we're going to publish a case study this week with a partner called GSN, Mobile Gaming Studio, based in the US. And they conducted their own A/B test, and they saw a 12% revenue uplift. So we're still working on measuring our own test, and we will publish them in the coming weeks. But the first test that I'm able to share today officially is a 12% revenue uplift.
Okay, I'm going to kick off with one then. Given that it's a crowded marketplace, lots and lots of app developers and mediation platforms, What are the biggest areas that you think the mediation platforms need to solve at this given time?
There are many. I would say one is trust and transparency. More specifically, fraud. For instance, like looking at what MoPub is doing, we're working with a lot of third-party partners to make sure that our ad exchange is as healthy as possible, but also to provide insights to our customers, whether that's on the buy side, on the supply side, on best practices and how healthy what they do is, if that makes sense.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, that makes sense. You see a lot of ad formats through your mediation.
Mm-hmm.
Give me an insight into maybe one or two that are doing exceptionally well for publishers, rewarded video, whatever.
Sure.
Whatever you fancy.
Sure. Well, I think it's fair to say that when it comes to gaming, rewarded video has been doing extremely well for publishers over the past 3 years. And we really saw this format taking off. That said, what I was not expecting like 12 months ago, so at MoPub we invested a lot of resources into making the whole rewarded video and video full screen experience as good as possible. I was not expecting that banners will be still hanging around. And actually we're still seeing with publishers that are relying on banners extremely healthy performances. And it has been one of the fastest growing formats on the platform over the past 12 months. So I guess the takeaway here is to say that banners are not dead. And even though it's not necessarily an appealing format from a gameplay perspective, it is still very effective from a monetization standpoint.
Hi, can you speak a little bit about how your sort of mediation waterfall works and how you actually find the best paying ad?
I'm going to need another 30 minutes. So I think that if you want more insights on how our mediation works, please come downstairs. We have a booth. We can sit down and I can walk you through it, or the team will. But I guess at a high level, the idea is like we want to make it as simple as possible. And that's why we're moving to in-app header bidding at what we call advanced bidding. To improve the operational efficiency of the platform. No, I'm good.
Okay, thank you very much. That was a great session. Thanks.
Thank you.